Life is a hard game, don't you blame. It's your chance to rise your aim. Let your spirit be brave, always fight to hold your name. No matter how bad or rough, you never surrender.
Master, won't Bruce be able to teach us anymore?
I heard he'll be needing a while to fully recover.
Master Kimura, is Bruce really a paraplegic now?
If Bruce won't be able to teach us Kung Fu anymore, then I'll just have to drop out.
Just what do you guys think you're talking about? Huh? Who told you that Bruce won't be able to walk anymore? How can you say that? You can't even respect him. If you want to leave, then go ahead. Get out of here.
What's wrong? Huh? Why do you talk like that? Are you out of your mind?
Master, all of us here are concerned about Bruce Lee.
Master, we all love Kung Fu. That's why we'll just wait for Bruce until he comes back.
That's right.
Yeah, yeah. That's right.
We won't leave. We won't leave.
Everyone, thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you all. Come here, Kimura.
They know Bruce, but they don't know who Blair or Jesse are. Though I want to teach them, they're just unwilling. I think it'll be hard for us to stay afloat.
Starting tomorrow, I'll train the students myself.
Would it be hard for you?
Stop it. You know I have to. Since Bruce got injured badly, many students have already left. I'm sure you know that Bruce's recovery will take a while. We can't just wait here, you know. We need to keep the Kung Fu school running. We can't stay idle. You're his student and his best friend. You need to give him all your support. What I mean is, you have to help Bruce. You can't just give up. We must take care of this school.
Uncle Chow, I'm sorry. I'm just so worried about him. But don't worry. Just for Bruce, I'll make sure I'll stay tough. I won't give up.
Good.
Hey.
Linda.
Hi.
How are you?
Bruce, I'll prepare some drinks. You guys just talk, all right? I'll be right back.
So, Bruce, tell me, are you feeling better?
Uncle, it looks like I'm going to have to say goodbye to martial arts.
Don't tell me you're giving up. Listen to me. From this day onward, you're not allowed to say stupid things like that, huh?
All right, then, I won't. Hey, Kimura, let me ask you, how's the school doing?
Well, it's all right.
Nothing wrong going on there?
No, of course. Right, Uncle Chow?
Yes. Actually, it's not the same now. I mean, it's gotten better even though you're out. Huh?
It's my body that's injured now. But I'm still very okay right here. I know, you're so obvious. You're lying to me.
We're not. We're being honest.
Really? You don't have to make up lies. I know a lot of students have left.
A few, but there are still some. I guess.
How many are still around?
About half of them.
Just about half.
Bruce, isn't that good news? The only thing you have to do now is to make sure that you'll recover. Kimura and I will deal with things you can't attend to. We'll always support you, so don't worry, okay?
Uncle, help me. I need help to get on the wheelchair.
What's the matter?
Something has been bothering me a lot. I'm thinking it's about time that we make a decision.
Bruce, are you saying that?
I think we should close our Kung Fu school.
Bruce, should we do that?
We must. We have to do that. We can't cheat our students who respect and value Kung Fu. We'll let them go.
Bruce, I don't think that's wise. Think hard. We can't close our school just because of your injury. Give it some time, okay? Maybe a month or so. If there's no progress, then that's when you can decide.
He's right, Bruce. It's easy to close it, but reopening it will be hard.
I know that.
Then why?
Come on. We're obviously wasting each other's time here.
Bruce, I think you really need to listen to Kimura. You can't rush your decision on this right now.
No. I'm closing it down. That's final.
Bruce, can you at least give us your reasons?
Reasons? I'll give you my reasons. Do you know whose name that school carries? It's my name. Where am I now? I'm in a wheelchair. I can't even stand. How can I teach students? It doesn't make sense. That's why I'm saying, close it down.
Hey, Kimura. Kimura, stop that.
Uncle Chao, I won't let the school close down. It's not right. I can't accept it.
You know I don't want this to happen myself. But we don't have any other choice now.
But we can't just give up like this.
No. Kimura. We're closing the Kung Fu school like Bruce wants. But I'm very sure we'll be able to open it again someday. Like an old proverb says, men only weep when grieved. You have to keep that in mind. You're a real man. Huh?
Uncle Chao, Kimura. Bruce asked me to give you this. He told me to give you the school's earnings. Uncle Chao.
He doesn't have to do this. He's the one who needs money.
Don't refuse Bruce. He really insists that I give this to you. It's his gift to everyone. All of you worked hard for this school. Uncle Chao, come on, please take the money. All right? Thanks.
Did you give them their share? So they do have their money now?
Yes.
I got nothing to worry about then. You know what?
What?
It was all of my friends who helped build that school, but now it's gone forever. So I felt like I shouldn't leave them with nothing. They should at least get something.
Well done. You really made them happy.
Hey, I've got some news. I think my arms and legs are better now.
Really? I told you miracles do happen.
Yeah, I'm very sure. That's really what's making me better. You know what I want? I want to stun the American medical authorities.
That's right, Bruce. Those doctors are ignorant. They know nothing.
They know nothing?
That's right.
All right. I want to continue with the recovery therapy.
Okay.
Okay.
By the way, do you know about the company's products?
I don't just know your company's products. I also know the latest features included in each of them. I can do sales too.
Oh, that's good.
Thank you.
We'll call you. Next, please.
Hello, I just graduated from college, but I know I can be an asset to the company.
Sir, may I have your name, please?
My name's Mark. I have sales experience, by the way.
That's good. Please fill out this form. Next, please.
My name's Robin. I'm actually quite interested in marketing and sales.
Oh, that's good then.
Thanks.
Hi. Come on, Linda. Don't be sad. You'll get one soon. Hey, it's okay, honey. Look, I can get books on my own now. You see that?
I told you do make miracles happen. Come on, Bruce. Let's start with your exercise.
No. I've already finished doing it.
Huh? You did it by yourself?
No, not really. Uncle Chow and Kimura came and helped me out. Blair and Jesse, too. They gave me a hand with the therapy. They even said that they'd come here every day to help me out, Linda. Don't worry too much, okay?
Wait. I mean, you shouldn't ask them to come here every day. Now that the Kung Fu school's closed, they need to start a new life.
Yeah, I know that, but Uncle says he'll come here every day. He also wants to get me cured. He'll use this Chinese medicine on me to help me recover.
Uncle Chow knows about Chinese medicine?
Of course, he used to sell herbs before. He did that when he really had no money. Besides, he's a martial artist. He's probably developed ways to cure himself. And he wants to apply it to me. If Uncle will be able to help me using his methods, then that will be great, right?
Where's the paper? I think I need to have a look at the classifieds.
Oh, in the drawer.
Oh.
What is it?
Why is there money in here?
I don't know.
Well, as far as I know, I've already given this to Uncle Chow.
Oh, they gave it back. They think that we need money more than they do, so they decided to return this.
They didn't have to. I know our situation's difficult, but so are theirs.
It's okay. Let's not use this. When they come here again, I'll ask him to take this money.
You are lucky to have them as your friends.
I know. And that's why I want to give the money back to them.
Good.
I will.
You stupid girl! You don't know how to use a lawnmower! Why did you apply for this job? I give you your money, and all you do is wreck my lawnmower.
I'm sorry, sir, but this is too old.
Shut up! The mower's designed to last for 10 years, and it's been used for only 9 years, okay? So how can you say that it's the problem? You know what I think? I think there's something wrong with you. You're fired. Get out of here. Get out!
Mr. Klintzman.
What do you want? Can't you see I'm busy right now?
I read your ad in the newspaper. I'm here to apply for the job.
Yeah, I did post an ad. But in case you didn't notice, I was looking for a housekeeper.
Exactly. That's the reason why I went here.
Are you kidding me, miss?
No, I'm not kidding. I really want to apply for the job you posted in the newspaper.
I can't. You're white. I can't pay you more than I pay the others. It's impossible.
Why not? I'm here because I really need to get a job.
But you're white. I wasn't intending to get a white housekeeper, you know?
I know... I'm white. But Mr. Klinsman, I really need money right now.
Fine. You're hired then.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Sure. If you like, you can start tomorrow, all right?
I will. See you tomorrow.
What are you doing? Have some more. Come on. Drink it. Drink it all. You have to finish it.
I'm sorry, Uncle. I got your shirt all messed up.
That's okay. You know what? Chinese medicine is bitter, but it works really well. It gives our body tons of energy. It can heal major injuries, you know, whether it's broken arms or ribs. That's why you have to keep taking this. And of course, you have to couple it with acupuncture. This will help you too. Acupuncture will allow your cells to regenerate and grow rapidly.
Acupuncture?
Yes.
I never knew you practiced acupuncture.
I've been taking your aunt to doctors for so many years. I learned this just by watching. Of course, on my own, I studied too.
Oh, I see.
You know what? Acupuncture is like magic. It's not only able to heal you rapidly, there's still something more. Wait, I'll show you. You see, it gives the body treatment by relaxing the body and its environment. That's called the concept of entirety.
Concept of entirety?
Yes.
Actually, come to think of it, Kung Fu has that concept. You see, in defense and offense, one has to maintain the body's harmony. That must be done to release the power of Yung Chun Chuan.
You're obsessed with martial arts. You believe everything can be related to it.
Okay. Let me hear your theory about Chinese medicine, all right?
Sure.
Go ahead.
In acupuncture, you have points. Li Qi controls your head. For your back, it's Wei Zhong. That's why I'll be focusing on Wei Zhong. You feel that? How about that?
Uncle?
It seems that your body points are all blocked now.
Am I really useless now?
Bruce, you shouldn't say that.
I just remembered a fight.
What fight?
Now I know. Our kung fu, in actual combat, has disadvantages. For example, in Hong Zhuan's teachings, as well as Master Ye's Yung Chun Chuan, there are things that don't apply to real fighting.
Come to think of it, you're right about that.
I think that traditional martial arts and kung fu styles, patterns, and movements are outdated. They've stagnated. What I want is to empty the glass and to fill it up again. That's my goal now.
Empty the glass and fill it up again. That's philosophy right there.
Recently, since I've been stuck on a wheelchair, I've thought of many things, like theories, especially of Kung Fu. I'll use my time to empty my own glass and then fill it up. Eventually, I'll become wiser and better.
I'm glad you've stayed positive. I'm happy for you.
Well, I can't just sit and do nothing, right?
Actually, since the time that you had your fight with Wong Jackman, I realized that you were slowly getting rid of the style of Yong Chun Tuan. Which means that your system of martial arts is slowly developing now.
Thing is, I can't even stand up now. Uncle Chao, can you bring my pen and paper here? I just want to write down some things I've thought about.
Bruce?
Have you found a job?
Yes. Actually, I was just about to tell you that I found one already.
What kind of job?
It's kind of like a clerical job at a small advertising company down the street.
Good. Linda.
Yes.
Linda, you look very tired right now. You don't have to cook. We can just order out.
Bruce, I just don't want the house to smell again.
You don't have to cook. Just call an order. I want to help you, but I just can't.
All right. Oh. Isn't working. You've got to replace this.
What do you mean, obsolete? You're just being stupid. You're not using it properly. It's so obvious that you're making up excuses. I'll reduce your paycheck. I don't care if you're a white woman.
Mister, it's true that this lawnmower is designed to last for 10 years, but you've used it for 9 years already. Don't you think it's obsolete?
Okay, it's a little old. I know that. But all of its parts are still in tip-top condition. I fired an Asian girl because she was so dumb. I thought you could do better than her, but apparently you're even more useless. Get out of here!
Are you firing me?
Don't make me repeat what I said, miss.
You'll see. I'll show everyone the contract we signed. I'll make the Workers' Union and the Women's Association tell you how to respect women and all other people. Remember, everyone has the same dignity as you.
If what you're saying is true, you won't do that kind of work. I'm sorry, I didn't see your hand.
It's obvious. Don't deny it. I know you really did that on purpose.
What's that? You're accusing me?
I'm warning you. Touch me and I won't be easy on you.
Fine, then let me see how good you really are. I've never seen a woman as violent as you. I don't believe this.
Don't come near me.
Sorry, all right? I didn't mean it. I know I cut your finger, but it was an accident. It's not on purpose. Hey! Wait a minute! Get your paycheck before you leave!
Remember that we signed a contract, mister. It's clearly stated there that you can only fire me after I've worked for you for at least a month. I'll bring you the medical bill you'll have to pay. And don't forget to buy a new lawnmower.
What are you drinking there?
The medicine.
Are you sure?
It's my recipe. It's quite nice. Listen, you know what? I put some vegetable juice in here, so it's different. It looks better, right? It's great. I thought that if I just sit here, my digestion would slow down, so I decided to juice vegetables so I can get nutrition. Through juicing, I get nutrients and minerals. Every day, Linda and I eat junk food. We hardly get to eat vegetables. That's why I juice the vegetables and mix them with my medicine. That way, the medicine's no longer that bad.
That was really smart.
Even though you're stuck at home right now, you still managed to think of that.
Come on, let's start with the therapy, right?
Sure.
Linda, you're home.
Yes, I was a bit busy today. That's why I came home a little late. Are you all right? Did Uncle Chow drop by?
He did. He helped me with my therapy. He massaged my legs and used acupuncture.
Oh, why didn't you invite him for dinner?
He hates pizza. Back in his earlier years, that's what he always ate. That's why now, when he hears about it, he feels sick.
Oh, same here.
Yeah.
Let's go inside.
No.
Well, then why did the vegetables disappear?
I ate them.
You ate all the vegetables without cooking them?
Kind of. You see, I used that thing over there to make vegetable juice. And it worked pretty good.
Listen, this washing machine is not a juice extractor. You wash clothes with it. Oh my goodness, I just put all the laundry and there's vegetable juice in here.
What did you say? Oh, you shouldn't have, Linda. Look what happened to my juice now. I have nothing to drink anymore. My dinner's all ruined. Oh, pizza's here.
Oh, pizza, pizza, pizza. My goodness. It's pizza every day. Oh. And it's Italian pizza. I'm sick of it. Oh.
Hey, what happened to your finger?
Oh, nothing. Just got a bit careless.
Can you tell me what really happened?
Oh, nothing. I just tried some of the kung fu moves you taught me. It's because of this crazy guy that pissed me off big time. I just had to do it.
I don't understand. You got in a fight?
It's not a fight. Just self-defense.
Wait a minute. Tell me, Linda, just what on earth is your job?
Didn't I tell you the day before I work as a clerk in an advertising company?
Don't lie to me, Linda. If you're a clerk in a company, then how'd you get into a fight? That's impossible. I know. You're hiding something from me.
No, Bruce. I'm not.
I'm your husband. I have the right to know. Tell me.
I didn't want to hide anything. I didn't get what I really wanted, but that's okay. At least I still have a job.
Okay, but you have to tell me what it is.
It's housekeeping.
What?
It's temporary.
Linda, tell me how your finger got injured.
I was careless and got cut by a lawnmower.
Oh man, I just hate myself right now.
Bruce, listen, believe me. It's not that bad, I promise.
Linda, you listen. You made a very big mistake when you married me. You should leave me and go back to Seattle now. You should go back to your mother, Linda. I'm telling you, I won't let you have that kind of job.
Bruce.
No. Do this for me. You must quit that job.
Listen, it's not that bad, Bruce.
It is. You shouldn't have chosen me. I'm useless. I'm the biggest loser this world has ever known. Bruce Lee's the worst man ever.
Bruce.
You got injured because of me, Linda. I owe you so much.
Stop it, Bruce. It's okay. Believe me. That's why I want to get through this with you. That's why I have to work. I'm doing this job now, but I'll quit soon, okay? I promise.
You have to leave that job now. I don't want you to suffer.
Listen. Wait till I get my paycheck. Then I'll quit that job, okay?
Okay. We'll wait.
Good. Hi.
Hey, hi there.
So you bought a new one. Here, this is for you.
Don't worry, I'll give this amount back to you.
Thank you. At least we have an understanding.
Pretty much, I guess.
You want me to do that?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Don't be so depressed, please. Bruce.
But you have to listen to me.
All right. I'll listen to what you say, okay? But you've got to promise me one thing.
Okay. What's that?
You know what? I have been thinking about what God has given us as our purpose.
What is it?
I think we need to write down your kung fu techniques and martial arts theories. The kind of intelligence you have and the name Bruce Lee will guarantee that many publishers will publish your book.
So you're saying that I should write a book?
Yes. I'm sure a lot of publishers are waiting.
All right. We'll do that.
Great.
Okay. Come on.
Let's go do it.
Okay. Learning Kung Fu will influence both our philosophy and lifestyle. Through constant training from different masters, one can reach a great level. Still, one needs to keep on learning. Studying traditional martial arts will give someone traditional learning. In mastering martial arts, one must have an open mind and heart as well. Martial arts' core is freedom.
I got it. Keep going.
To prepare for a fight, first, before and after one attacks, one must be sure of his opponent's skills to ensure a win. Second, before and after a fight, one must be sure of his defense. In that manner, one will be efficient in eluding attacks. Last, one must study how he will be able to penetrate someone's defense and to inch closer to someone's zone of attack. That is so you will be able to limit his attacks. Doing so will also help block an opponent's movements, which will help in delivering the strongest counterattack.
Okay, that's all typed now. How about saying something about mental preparations?
To prepare one's mind, first of all, one must have sufficient desire to fight. One must know how to be motivated for battle. Second, one must know his enemy. And third, one must be able to maintain vigor. Fourth, one must be vigilant to sudden changes in defense and offense.
Look at this. The change is drastic.
Even here, it's obvious. We better examine him again.
Like what I said, his recovery is much better than expected. He's in his best condition. Don't be so tense.
You're saying that he won't walk anymore?
This is science, Mrs. Lee. I want to keep your hopes up, but I can't just give you a baseless conclusion.
But it's possible that he'll walk again. Am I correct?
Your husband's recovery is really better than expected, but that's no guarantee. Going back to his condition before the injury, I will have to say, is quite slim or even. Almost impossible.
Can't we expect a miracle?
The kind of recovery that your husband made is already a miracle. What's up, Linda?
What did he tell you?
You want to hear what he said?
Of course.
He said that your recovery is amazing. It's really a miracle.
Are you serious?
Yes. That's right. Even he was surprised. He didn't expect that you would recover so well. You amazed him.
But I still can't stand up.
You'll stand up again.
Did the doctor say that?
What did I say? Bruce makes miracles happen.
That's right.
Come on.
We'll wait for you outside,
okay.
Then.
You want water?
No.
Bruce? Tomorrow morning, I'll be taking Brandon back. Mama's a little old now. She tires easily. It's hard for her to babysit.
It looks like I'll have to compete with our little baby this time. I don't want Brandon to see me right now. Not when I'm like this. Not in a wheelchair.
Hello, Linda. Bruce.
Oh, hey. Hi.
Are you better now?
Uncle.
Have a seat.
Just in time. I was about to call you up.
Really now? Well, you don't have to call me. What's going on?
Actually, I want to talk to you about opening the school again.
Oh, that's great.
What's great about that? He suddenly closed a kung fu school just a few months back. Now you changed your mind? What do you really want? I don't get you. What are you thinking?
Right now, I feel that my body's getting better as each day passes. In that case, I'll be fully recovered in about half a month. And the first thing I want to do is open the school again.
Bruce, I don't think it's going to be that easy. Relax. You don't have to rush. I think that's not important. There are other things you need to think about. You know what? What you really need to think about is how to get completely well. By then, we can talk about the school. It won't be too late, right?
Bruce, what Uncle Chow said is right. Reopening the Kung Fu school isn't easy. I think it's better for us to wait until you've recovered completely. I mean, you don't have to be in a hurry.
Maybe you're just too negative, you know? That I won't get well.
No. That's not what I'm saying, okay? I just don't want your recovery to be interrupted by this.
I went there a few days ago. I'm sure the door's still locked. If you want to, I'll open it right away. Just tell me when. Besides, good. I think all our former students would re-enroll once we open.
Very good, that's great.
You heard that?
Recently, I thought about this. Our school needs a system of its own. We need a martial arts concept. It has to be original. What I mean is,
go ahead.
I want to make my own martial arts system. I want to provide training using the theories and concepts that I wrote. Tell me, what do you think? Is that being too arrogant?
Bruce, Don't mind what people say, because I don't think you're being arrogant. What I'm saying is your system is developed already, and you ought to be proud.
Kimura, why are you quiet? You got nothing to say?
What I want to say is, the great master of martial arts is back.
Man, just look at this guy. What's happening? Is he sick or something? Don't bluff, Kimura. You don't like giving compliments. You're not being natural.
Bruce, believe me, I'm being honest. What's the matter with Linda?
She's okay. Linda's helping me write a book on my martial arts. By now, we'll start working on the training outline.
That's great, Bruce. Don't forget to continue doing your therapy exercises. Also, I think it would help if I treat you with acupuncture. That way you'll recover much faster.
Ma'am, this is science. I'm sorry, but I can't give you a baseless conclusion. Your husband's recovery is astonishing, but that's not a guarantee. Going back to his condition before the injury, I will have to say, it's really very slim, maybe impossible.